This is the second page of the rubric. So if you were to scroll up, you'd see the first, obviously. This is the second page of the rubric. Now, your midterm is going to be a 10-minute presentation explaining how you teach a lesson and explaining how you teach that lesson in the context of the three major strands of our course. The three major strands of this course are pedagogy, right here, and brainy bits, the biological perspective, and technology. Okay. You are also going to be writing out your presentation, as we spoke about in class, in the notes section. And I'll talk to you about some samples of what that might look at momentarily. Once again, you're not presenting the lesson to us. Rather, you are discussing how you teach this lesson and what elements of this lesson lend themselves to the different things that you've learned in our class. Now, excuse me, I'm going to scroll up and take a look at the rubric. The rubric, if you're not familiar with them, is a scoring system by which we will assess your PowerPoint and your presentation. Be very clear on this. Most of these points here are going to be done or graded during your actual presentation when you actually stand up and talk to us. Therefore, your content has to be presented orally. It has to be written in the notes section, and your PowerPoint are going to be bulleted pieces that support that content. In a rubric, this first line here, this horizontal line here, is a strand, and it stops at 4 points. This is the overall portion over here. I'm sorry, this far right column. This is a general synopsis of what the strand is all about. However, where you want to look for the details of the strand is right here in this area. Your objective is to do everything on this page, and your objective is to go across all of the levels of each of the strands. So the first strand deals with the presentation pieces, or the overall presentation of the lesson. So you're going to tell us who your target audience is. You're going to do the target audience, which is the previous box, and you're going to tell us your goals and objectives. And then here you're going to do the previous box, which is goals and objectives and target audience, and you're going to identify defined outcomes. And in order to get 4 points on this particular strand, you are also going to do the three previous boxes, as well as talk about techniques for evaluation and assessment. The next strand deals with teaching strategies, and these are basically pedagogical concepts. And some of these pedagogical concepts in here we haven't yet learned, because Donna will be presenting next week. However, you will have all the information you need 2 weeks before the midterm, so you'll have time to work that out. The next piece deals with technology, and here what you're going to be looking at is the technology that you use during the course of the lesson and how that technology reaches different learning styles, multiple intelligences, different parts of the brain. Why is it you're choosing that technology, and how is that technology enhancing your lesson? Here, this particular piece is on the brain research. Now, notice here that this is about neurons and sensory input, cerebral lobes, and limbic system. Keep in mind, you are not going to teach us any of the concepts that you're seeing here. As a good example, you are not going to stand up and try to teach us about learning styles. You do not need to explain multiple intelligences to us. We know what those mean. Similarly, you don't have to be a biologist in order to achieve good results on this brain strand. What you're going to do is you're going to talk about how in your classroom you have perhaps things that are stimulating and invoke different senses, and therefore stimulate or provide sensory input to your students. And you're going to be specific. You know, perhaps you're going to say, within my lesson I have lemons, which the student can feel, smell, and taste, and those are the senses that are impacted there. You're also going to talk about the cerebral lobes, as Dr. Christini talked about in her lecture yesterday. And there, again, you're not going to tell us specifically what those lobes do or how they function, but rather you are going to talk about the fact that perhaps during your lesson, you do certain activities that stimulate certain parts of the lobe. For example, if you're running a video, you can certainly say that showing students a video stimulates the occipital lobe. The limbic system, Dr. Christini talked about Amy Gedalia or the amygdala, and there you're going to be talking about the amygdala, the hippocampus, the thalamus, those types of things, how emotion makes information stick longer, how the hippocampus brings down information from past experiences and puts it into working memory for the moment. So again, you're not going to be a biologist. You're not going to have to worry about explaining how or why those things work, but rather how your lesson stimulates those parts of the brain. This strand is about the volume, clarity, and organization of the presentation. And of course, this is something that just, you know, again, builds from point one to point four. Notice here, you do have a point that's dedicated to being within the 10-minute time frame. The next box deals with your PowerPoint design and whether or not your slides are well organized and they are eye-friendly and that it is visually appealing or engaging the audience. Okay, keep in mind, all of these strands here, this one all the way through here, you will be presenting this content to us orally while using your PowerPoint presentation. This last strand assesses the note section that you will write on your PowerPoint presentation. Now, this is not something that's assessed during your presentation, but rather it's assessed after your presentation by Dr. Christini to take a look at all of the details. And in this particular note section, you will need to, again, write out everything that you're going to say in the presentation, and you're going to have to also give some references. Now, in terms of exemplary,